We're all made of the same basic chemicals. We're all made of
DNA.
Dinosaur genes are made of DNA. So you and I are the product of billions of years of tiny changes to our DNA. They happen every time living things make copies of themselves. Like every time we have children, when your grandparents had your parents, and when your parents had you. This process of change is called evolution. It's the reason we all look the way we look.
A clip from the Emmy Award-winning series, Bill Nye the Science Guy, focusing on evolution. That is the focus in Undeniable Evolution and the Science of Creation. Its author, Bill Nye, joins us now. The book already doing well.
Yes.
Excellent.
It's number 8.
Oh, my God.
So that is good. So tell us about the book. Why did you write it?
To change the world.
Really?
And has the world been sufficiently changed?
Well,
can
see,
you now go home and leave your book?
Is it over?
Yeah. So evolution is the fundamental idea in all of life science.
Right.
And we have a large fraction of people in the world's most technologically advanced nation that sort of don't accept it.
Yeah.
And so when there's
that's his party, by the way.
Well,
that's his crazy, wacky party.
Come on,
just
now.
Just saying.
No.
We have more in common. We're more alike than we are different.
Okay, let's all
exactly. Yeah.
Thank you, Bill.
Bill.
No, and that's the point.
Donnie is always trying to divide. We are trying to unite.
So that's one of the points of evolution. You know that there really, in a sense, is no such thing as race. Mm-hmm. You know, if you have some.
Tell his crazy party that also.
Oh, man.
Donnie, we're going to have to pull you
just
from the sass.
So, but for example, just by way of example, just run this thought experiment.
Yeah.
If a Norwegian woman interacts, can we say interact?
That's a good word to use.
Yeah.
What do you mean by interact?
Has sex, procreate.
Oh.
With somebody from Papua New Guinea, you're just going to get a human. That's all you're going to get. You're not going to get some new thing.
Right.
And this is sort of a fundamental idea in evolution. Yeah.
So let's get to the crux of your book. What do you want to accomplish here? What message do you want to send?
That evolution is the fundamental idea in all of life science, and it is both humbling and empowering. When you realize that you are a product of 4.5 billions of just trial and error of chipping away at this thing,
right.
Then I hope you'll cut yourself some slack. Everybody you've ever met has made it this far. Everybody you've ever met is good enough to get here.
Yeah.
Even my old boss, huh?
Yeah,
really?
Comedy's that simple. I was never sure.
Very, very good.
Let me ask you a question. Does the fact that fewer people are believing in evolution suggest that maybe we aren't evolving?
I think the pendulum will swing. I think that, here's what keeps the United States in the game economically. We don't manufacture things here the way they did when I was a kid, or even especially when my father was a kid. What keeps us in the game is innovation,
mm-hmm.
new ideas. If you want an iPhone, if you want that computer that you're enjoying, if you want that plastic that your Boston Red Sox cup is made out of, you got to have innovators. You have to have new ideas, scientists, engineers. Engineers use science to make things and solve problems. If you have a group of people that continually suppresses science, then you're going to fall behind economically. And
so this
is why I'm concerned about young people.
So, I am a Southern Baptist. Orthodox in my belief. I'm a terrible Southern Baptist.
I'm not keeping records.
Backsliding Southern Baptist. Yeah, exactly. You're not the one to keep records. The big man is. But I've always, this debate has always come up, and it's always been an either or, a black or white. You either believe in Jesus or you believe in evolution. You either believe in God or you believe in evolution, blah, blah, blah. You know, the Pope said something a couple weeks ago that I've been saying since I was like 8 years old. Why does there have to be a conflict?
Well, if
you believe in the power of God, you believe that God has the power to set the events in motion, if that's what you believe. And, I mean, how helpful was the Pope's statement?
It's good. It's also good that the Pope accepted the findings of Galileo. That's more power to him. That's good. The problem is this organization, especially in Kentucky, has this diligent and complete program to indoctrinate young people that the Earth is somehow magically 6,000 years old. And that's it's not. It can't be.
Yeah.
So if you question that, then you question everything in geology. Like, for example, this Philly spacecraft, amazing thing.
Yep.
Billions of kilometers out in space, taking these astonishing pictures. If there were an asteroid or comet with our name on it, we need a space program to give it a little nudge.
Exactly. Right?
So if you don't believe in all this stuff, you're just going to not do anything about it.
I saw Armageddon.
The book is.
That space program.
So here's the thing, you guys. We don't want to blow it up.
Okay.
Don't want to blow it up.
Blow the,
got to give it a nudge.
We'll give it a nudge and just kind of push it away.
Thank you so much.
Bill, thank you.
And thank you, Joe. Coming up, for a limited time only, two of TV's biggest stars will be performing live on Broadway together. Alan Alda, Candace Bergen. Join us in our next hour.